Governor Jerry Brown recently signed a measure that allows doctors-assisted suicide in California. The law requires two physicians to confirm the patient's mental competence and prognosis, and the medication has to be self-administered. Many are speaking out against the law, saying it goes against the purpose of medicine and could jeopardize the lives of the disabled and elderly. And joining us now by Skype is Dr. Gracie Christie, who specializes in radiology. Thanks a lot for joining us today.
Oh, you're welcome. It's a pleasure.
You have recently written a piece entitled "Assisted Suicide Means the End of Medicine." What do you mean by that?
That these bills that have been passed in several states now, including California, are co-opting medicine and making it a part of this culture of death, where instead of medicine being a vocation that chases away death and leads to the well-being of men and women, instead they're making us executioners and making us part of this love of death as a human right.
How do you see doctors right now responding to this new measure?
Well, in general, doctors are against these laws. Every medical association in the country has come out strongly against these laws, except for the California Medical Association, which declared itself recently neutral. In general, doctors are against it because it's entirely against our vocation. It's against our education and everything that we went into medicine for.
How do you see the right to die affecting the everyday practice of medicine both now and in years to come?
Well, and there's a couple ways it affects it negatively. First of all, it enshrines suicide as an honorable and decent solution that we offer to people who are near death or in pain, which is not medically sound, especially nowadays when we have different from the rest of human history, we have these amazing drugs that where we can treat pain and make people comfortable towards the end of their lives. And also it changes the relationship between doctors and patients because it puts an element of distrust. The patient doesn't know if the doctor is going to give up on him or her when care becomes difficult or expensive.
Wow. Well, when you think about Christians responding to this, what do you think is a good way for Christians to think about this kind of legislation?
Well, again, this is one of the terrible encroachments on the dignity of life, whether it's the beginning of life or the end of life or the life of the disabled, people who are ill or depressed. You know, we are telling people that there are some lives that are not worth living. And we know as Christians that there is no such thing. You know, every life is a gift. Every life should be lived to its fullest and, you know, to our natural end. And our lives can always be a gift to others, even when we, you know, when our lives are difficult. So as Christians, we need to come out strong against this, you know, inform ourselves what's going on in each of our states and let our legislators know that this is not correct. This is not a good thing for our country.
What is your response to defenders of this who say, you know, this kind of assisted suicide is really a way of showing mercy?
Well, some people believe that, but it's a false kind of mercy. Because people who are desperate enough to want to kill themselves, those people don't need help killing themselves. They need companionship. They need palliative care. They need hospice. They need their brothers and sisters to turn towards them and offer them a helping hand, not, you know, not hurry them out the door. So it's not real compassion. It's false compassion.
What is your message to young people today who are thinking about going into medicine?
You know, that's a good question because I worry. I have older children that talk about it. Medicine more and more is becoming is under attack. You know, medicine, they want these forces, progressive forces, want to put medicine in their pocket, put us doctors in their pocket and make us part of their agenda. And we have to fight against it because medicine is a holy vocation in a way, and we need to keep it that way.
Dr. Gracie Christie, thank you so much for your insights and your time.
You're welcome. It's a pleasure.